with what Joanna said, the two slides are about the composition of the largest exporters and the Security Council permanent members. If you make just a typo mistake when you type, I mean, you are fast, you are not patient, you are right in a hurry, then if you write UN Security Council and you forget the space between UN and security, you will have the right thing, on Security Council. Actually, it is a military junta that mostly approves and adopts resolutions for wars more than peace. So I don't know why is it called Security and Peace Council. It is a military junta, more or less. Just to add, regarding the Middle East, a couple of figures, I know he will correct me, I'm sure, because they will be wrong, but they are based on Cypri. The total weapon deals, every single year is over 1.7 and plus trillion dollars. I don't know how you can write that, how many zeros, I don't know. I mean, your problem. But out of it, 47%, according to Cypri again, would go to Asia. And Asia means basically India. Then comes the Middle East. You can find, for instance, Saudi Arabia, Nobel Peace Award, Barack Obama, with all my respect, decided to sell to Saudi Arabia between $5 billion to $50 billion deals in weapons. If you count the population of Saudi Arabia and you exclude the migrants, who are 60% of it, you will find that you would have some 5 to 10 tanks, or jets or whatever, per person, including children and my mother-in-law. She doesn't live there. So, and of course there is no human way that you teach them in 5 minutes, in English or in Arabic, whatsoever, how to use that, and especially you need spare parts. So that's an extra expense, an extra thing. Regarding Israel, I was not intending to talk about Israel, but facts are facts. And Egypt, every single year, that's, we are talking about the total arms business over the world. But every single year, the US gives Israel a grant for $10 billion. And gives Egypt a grant, no, you don't need, grant of $1,250,000,000. But if you go to the figures, I mean, if you search a bit, it is there anyway, you would see that out of the $1,250,000,000 every year to Egypt, $1 billion are not money, are not assistance. Nothing. It is a kind of a credit line for Egypt to buy weapons in the United States. Egypt would not receive the billion a year. It would just have a kind of a paper saying go and shop in the United States. So the producers would benefit enormously, and this money would be paid by the US administration to the US companies, and Egypt would not see one single word, one single dollar, except weapons. I mean, take this. Okay? I mean, this is what your voucher allows you to take. Big or small, good or bad, never mind. Okay? As you very rightly said, the Middle East is the mother of all conflicts. It is extremely rich. Forget about oil, okay? I mean, there are much more oil producers and exporters outside the Middle East than in the Middle East. I mean, listen, Norway, the United Kingdom, the US, big reserves. Look about, for instance, Venezuela. I mean, she is part, or they are part or not of the OPEC, no? So if you go to Nigeria and all that, I mean, not every oil producer is Arab or Muslim. I mean, they are minority. But anyway, the Middle East is extremely rich in conflict, as you very rightly said. And everybody, not only Germany, probably I was not aware about these shocking facts, but all the others are doing more or less the same exercise. I mean, remember big war between Iraq and Iran in the 80s? I mean, everybody was selling weapons to Iran and selling weapons, the same weapons, to Iraq. And they were killing each other. Unfortunately for the big business, the war lasted only 8 years. Bad business, eh? Should have continued up to now. And the Middle East will be, sentenced to conflicts for the coming 10 centuries, okay? Because then I will be retired and I will not need more information. But the point is that if you come here and say, are the Middle East people aware of that? People, okay? No, they are not. They are not. Because there is the fear policy imposed there. I mean, we have to buy weapons because otherwise Israel will kill us. We have to buy weapons because otherwise Egypt will kill us Israeli. And we have to buy weapons because otherwise we Saudis will be invaded by Iran, and we have to buy weapons because otherwise we Iran will be conquered by Saudi Arabia. Then the last report of Ban Ki-moon, UN Secretary General, about the state of children, last one, now, one week ago, he declared it, officially stated that I had to take a terrible decision, and that to cancel, erase, delete the name of Saudi Arabia as one country which is contributing to the killing of children in Yemen and other places whatsoever, because of pressures by the US and Saudi Arabia money, okay? So, I mean, according to the UN, Saudi Arabia did not kill anybody in Yemen, not one child, I mean, nothing at all. This is how it works. It is a big business. If the people are aware or not, no. I mean, and they are helpless, because if you go every day and say, unless we buy more weapons, we will be occupied. Remember, for instance, I remember in the 50s, the Nasserism, which everybody was Nasserist, I mean, not time, I was Nasserist, okay, but I was young. Would remind a kind of a speech of the president saying, do you want the United Kingdom and the British Empire to come back to Egypt and occupy Egypt and violate and abuse of our women and kill our children? No. Then from tomorrow on, the price of sugar will be double as expensive. It is the climate of fear. I mean, we have to have weapons because otherwise somebody will kill us. So the people are not aware, or they are aware, but they are helpless in that. Then it comes to the media, the role of the media. I don't know, you are too young, all of you, including you. I'm sorry, but I'll give an example from my age. There used to be a disco house, long place, no, you are young, which was called His Master's Voice. Okay? The brand would have a kind of speaker and a little dog seated there, seated there to repeat whatever comes from the loudspeaker. I mean, the master's voice. The Arab media, more or less, are playing this role. And the Arab politicians, we're talking about 22 countries, all of them full members of the Arab League officially, with a population of 385, 40, they reproduce fast, so it's say 400 million, okay? Now, and we're talking about 22 dictatorships. okay? All of them democratic dictatorships, mind you, right? I mean, all presidents and kings and so on are elected by 99% of the votes. So, more than Germany.
A little bit more.
Yeah, okay. So it is that, I mean, there is democracy there, there are votes and so on. So the media, now we come specifically to the media, and I have still, I think, 60 seconds, no, 22 seconds, half a minute, wow, hey. Okay. So, the media there is so restricted in its scope and in its action that, believe it or not, believe it, okay? Because you don't read Arabic, so you have to believe me. If a newspaper wants to report on a local event, local, and there is a dispatch from France Press, who is doing an excellent job in the Arab people, the Arabic service of France Press is fantastic, is very good. Reuters, or the BBC, you are BBC, right? Okay. CNN and blah, blah, blah. Then if there is a dispatch of one of these agencies and there is a dispatch from the national agency is the Ministry of Information of the any country, even the 22, then they would publish the one from Reuters, France Press, BBC, whatever. Why? Fear. Okay? If I have a newspaper and I say, I take a national media source, news agency, and say, the minister now has changed his mind and his politics, I say his, because they are all men, okay, I can see he or she, no? And decided to be pro-Palestinian or pro-refugees or anti-refugees, whatever. If I print it and the source is a national source, I will probably be in trouble because the ministry would call me and say, where did you bring that? But if it is Reuters, France Press, BBC, France Earth, okay, not even the minister can change it, okay? So, so we have that. I mean, you open a newspaper in Arab, in any Arab country, especially the Gulf, and you will see three lines news and say Reuters. But you said that the minister this morning opened the window. No, it has to be a foreign source. Okay. So the foreign sources are feeding this climate of fear. They, foreign sources of news, we are talking about 78% of, I mean, out of 100 words transmitted wired, television, whatsoever, radio, news agency, out of every 100 words, 79 would have a Western source. So, of course, the local media can talk about the wedding of the ambassador's daughter and a full page of photos, and if the prince or the king or the president, it is the same thing, send a telegraph, we are still talking about telegraph, to the king of Brunei saying compliments for your birthday. This can have local source because it comes from, you know, from God directly. So this is a situation. It will not change in the Middle East. No hopes. No hopes. You said that Germany was selling weapons to Gaddafi regime, to the rebels. I don't know why they call them rebels. I don't know. No, trust me. I mean, what happened in Cairo, and then I'll come back to that. What happened in Cairo, up to 30 million people in all Egyptian squares and so on, they are rebels or insurgents. Oh my God. But if this happens in France, and it happened, they are, this is the glorious revolution. So again, the Arabs are somewhere there. So back to it. what do you say?
You can close afterwards.
Yes, yes, I will close. No, if you want, I close now. You can see, I don't have glasses, I don't know what time is it. So, this is the real fact, the real situation, and it will never end. It will not change, no chance for it to change. I mean, we are stuck with this situation, we are stuck with German sales. Of course, you are doing an excellent effort, but it is here, and you, and the 100 organizations. But what about the United States? What about the United Kingdom? What about Russia? What about China? What about Canada? What about Norway being the seventh major supplier of what they call small weapons? They kill, killing machines. Okay, now she's looking at me with the left eye. So, thank you, Joanna. I don't have to say anything more. I think so. Thank you.